So here Krishna speaking Bhagavad Gita. Yeah, Maya Saptamana, about the yoga system, he has already concluded in the 6th chapter, the yoga system. And in the first six chapters, it is explained what is the constitutional position of the living entity. There are 18 chapters in the Bhagavad Gita. The first 6 chapters explains only the constitutional position of the living entity. And when it is understood, just like when you understand your actual position, then your activities actually begin. If you do not know what is your actual position, suppose in an office, if your post is not settled up, what duty you have to execute, then you cannot do anything very nicely. Here is a typist, here is a clerk, here is a peon, here is a this and that, so they are executing their work very nicely. So one has to understand what is the constitutional position of the living entity. So that is explained in the first 6th chapter. Adena satkena upasakasya jivasya sarupa tattvati sadhanancha pradhananyam proktam. The Baladev Vidyabhushan has a very nice authorized commentator on the Bhagavad Gita. He says that in the first 6 chapters, the constitutional position of the living entity has been very nicely explained. And how one can understand his constitutional position, that is also explained. So, the yoga system means to understand his constitutional position. Yoga Indriya Samyam. We are busy with sense activities. The material life means business of sense activities. The whole world activity, when you go stand on the street, you will see everybody is very busy. The storekeeper is busy, the motor driver is busy, everyone is very busy. So busy that so many accidents in business. Now why they are busy? If you minutely study what is their business, the business is sense getting. Yes. Everyone is busy how to gratify senses. This is material. And yoga means to control the senses, to understand my spiritual position, my constitutional position. Yes. Just like a boy who is accustomed, so, playing only, he cannot concentrate in his study, in understanding his future life, or in elevating himself higher position. Similarly, if we are engaged like child, without knowing the future of life, simply playing with the senses, That is called material life. The difference between material life and spiritual life is that if somebody is simply engaged in sense gratification business, that is called material life. And out of many thousands of such materialistic persons, if somebody is trying to understand what I am, why I have come here, why I am put into so many miserable conditions of life, is there any remedy? These questions, when arise, then practically his spiritual life begins. And the human form of life is meant for that. Hare Krishna.